We're going to do the flats panel setup on the telescope now. And once you put your telescope all together and your counterweights are set, because you don't, it depends, like sometimes I'll do my flats after the fact. Like, let's say last night I was outside. Let's say I shot 4 hours of 1 minute exposures, okay? And right after that, I put the lid on, so there, I'll put the lid on, like I'll park the telescope, and I'll put the lid on, it's 4 o'clock in the morning still, and Nina is still running, but it's, I'm done with the light frames, so I'll put the cap on, and without changing the length of the exposures, like the lights are 1 minute, the darks will be 1 minute. And so you leave everything the same, like don't warm up your camera. If it was -5, leave it on -5. And because it's really for convenience, even though you can do your darks other times, why not make them the one night? Because they'll last a month, as long as you stay with 60 seconds, as long as you stay with -5. And the gain and the offset, which we'll talk about later, should also stay the same. And then you can make a little library of 60 second darks at -5 with, you know, unity gain. So you do that, and then of course, maybe that takes from 4 o'clock to 5 o'clock in the morning, I don't know, depends when you stop imaging. And you want about 30 minimum and 50 maximum. So 50 times 60 seconds is 50 minutes, right? And 30 is 30 minutes, which is not that bad. Minimum 30 frames of darks. I'm still talking about darks, you know, we're gonna do nights, lights in a minute, I mean, flats in a minute. But then, you know, you're tired, you've been up all night, the telescope's, you know, you can even cover up the telescope while you're making darks, because the darker the better. And then the sun comes up, and hopefully everything's okay, and everything worked all right. But making your flats outside, now I'm going to explain to you what can happen in a minute when I set this up, is that you can get light leakage. Light leakage can come from, some people have a little filter drawer here. They have a filter drawer here. Light leakage can come from the spacing here, the spacing there. Here it's pretty airtight. No light can get in there. But I'm afraid of these sections here that are between the telescope. If there's a hole here, screw holes for these brackets, well, guess what? The light's going in. And the flats. Oh, and the darks. Make sure that when it's dark, everything, the lid's on it, everything's covered up, and there's no holes showing anywhere. That's why I put a big black plastic bag over the whole thing. But for the lights, if the telescope has to come back in the house, and or if you leave it outside, and let's say that tonight, last night was clear, but tonight's not clear, right? So tonight you're outside already, but it's like 9 o'clock or 10 o'clock. But it's cloudy, which is great, because you're outside, and you're not going to be imaging because it's cloudy. But now here's what you can do. You can flip your telescope and do your flats, which are lights, at night. But then, because you've now built yourself a light panel, the telescope will be lit up inside. So here's the deal. If you're still outside, or if you bring it all in the garage, or in some case I bring mine in the house, you want it on the mount. Why would you want the telescope on the mount? A while back, last year, I would have just put it on the table, and I would lean up the light panel against it. But there's this, it may fall over, or if you have a towel on, or a blank, or your t-shirt on, unless you have really strong elastic bands, the panel light, because, you know, it's really annoying, because it wants to fall, because okay? It's square, and you're sitting on the table, the telescope's like this, right? Mm-hmm. So this is better, and let's go through it. All right, so you're outside, and you're going to loosen your clutches. This is the deck, and the RA. Okay, so make sure you kind of hold on to both sides here. And I'm going to kind of go, you know, this way. And I'm going to put this completely horizontal. I'll lock it down. And I'm going to make sure that this is not like that or like this, because you don't want your panel sliding off. So whatever feels, looks, it doesn't have to be perfect. But, you know, you don't want it tilted this way or that way. So looks pretty close. Looks pretty close. Okay, so everything's there. Your camera's plugged in. Your cooler's still running at -5. Remember, you shut down between 4 and 7 o'clock in the morning or 8 o'clock in the morning. Now it's nighttime. A lot of things to remember. If you fire back up your camera, you have to go to -5 because you were at -5 the last night. But now the speed, the exposure is going to change to try to get your flats to remove to remove dust particles, vignette, things like that. And so you bring everything back up to speed. The only thing that's going to change is how fast you're going to shoot the exposures. So point number one is you have to put a white cloth on here. Now, I wish I had elastic bands, but for the purpose of illustration, like, you're going to want yours fairly tight, right? Don't have any creases like this. That's not going to work. So make it tight enough. I don't have elastic band, but these are not real flats. They're just to show you. And I've got two t-shirts. I'm going to put another one now. I can get all untangled. $5 at Dollarama. No. Country store. So if you can get them, these are too big. I wish I had made it. I wish I had bought smaller ones. And don't buy them with pockets. Man, that's annoying. Okay? Take all the pleats out. Whoa. My clutch is really, really tight, but it always slips. Yeah, it just went down a bit. So. Okay, so elastic band. Got a bag of big elastic bands. Make sure there's no bow out. For now, it doesn't matter because I'm just showing you how you can set up your t-shirts. Now, remember that panel you put together there last week or last month or whenever it was that we did the video? Well, now you're going to take it out. And, see, I had put foam on top of mine. And I had put the luminescent panel in between the two 5mm or 6mm. And so now you're going to want to put this, you know, average it out over the tube. But it's so nice because it's 10 by, I think this one's 10 by 10. I think it's 10 by 10. And now we're going to go through the whole plugging it all in. Once you have it all plugged in, then you'll have the controller in your hand. And we'll be able to vary the light that we need to vary based on what the exposure needs to be. You say, well, what's the exposure? Well, that's the next video. The next video you're going to get will come directly from my big computer, and I'm going to record my desktop, and I'm also going to have my my webcam. I'm going to have my webcam running, so if when I get out of the way, you'll actually be able to see the tube. You'll be able to see the light dim and get brighter. Hopefully, it's kind of far away. You may not see it, but at least I can walk you through and explain to you what's happening in Neena. And we'll do it just as if it was just as if you were outside, you know, or inside, and you're now ready to make beautiful flats that removes the big black vignette rings and little donuts. All there's always dust, and here's the thing: you take your camera and you look at it. You look at the sensor. Some sensors are bare. Other sensors have a IR UV cut filter, infrared and ultraviolet. And sometimes you look at it and go, I don't see anything. You take a magnifying glass or a flashlight and put your glasses on, you look up close, there's tiny, tiny particles. But those tiny particles on your image, like from the 533, they end up being literally Tim Hortons donuts. They're just everywhere. So if you keep it clean, less things to deal with. All you may have to deal with is the ring cone, which is like all the four corners end up darkened. Now this is all talk, and it's not going to make any sense until you do your first night shot, and then you stretch it and go, what's with all the black corners? Why is it? Well, that's the circle of light coming in towards the sensor, crossing over and making these black rings. The bigger the chip, the more vignette. The smaller the chip, if your cone's this big, you're not going to see the vignette. It's like on the outer side. So if you have just a small chip, you're okay. It's based on the focal length. Like F4 is a big cone, and F16 is probably a really small cone. So this is part one. I mean, it's not part one. It's the first part of the flats, because what's going to happen now is we're going to stop here. And even though we can't join those two, it's going to be part A, part B of part seven, which is the flats panel and flats maker. I'm just going to turn this on. Hopefully Barb will be able to see the Neena open. Yeah, so a second there. So in here, I'm going to fire up the camera. Not right now, because I'm going to do this as a recording. And then we're going to set the temperature. We set the temperature on there. And at one point, we're going to have to go here. If I can change it. We're going to go here. And we're going to go over here. And we're going to set like 1 second. and see where the histogram is, which is right here. And we'll see where the histogram is. I don't want to show you that right now because I'm not set up to start recording part two of the second section, the seventh section of the video. So hopefully that helps. So horizontal, two t-shirts. Why two t-shirts? Well, you could put one, but I think the reason for the t-shirt is that it also makes like a parameter around, like a soft parameter, so you're not putting the 4mm plastic on the metal, and then that could have little gaps or imperfections in the ring. So I put a t-shirt, one, and a second t-shirt, two, and then if you can afford to buy more than one of these electroluminescent, but these opaque plastic things, I'd rather have five. Because the more you have here, the more control you have over there. The light's always too bright. And sometimes if you use a wizard, it'll say, your light source is too bright. Bring it down. Well, I can't. I'm at the lowest I can go. Any lower and your light goes out. So it's always too bright. It's never not bright enough. You can really go bright. But what you can do is you never go low enough so you get a nice vignette correction or removing those motes. So maybe I will buy two more because, you know, now that I have my RC back. And that, I'd rather have this signal here, okay, higher up, and have to go through all these plastics than have it way down here where it's too dark and now it's taking 5 seconds for an exposure instead of one. And we really want to stay around 1 second, 2 seconds, and we'll make 30 of those, so 30 times 2 seconds at whatever gain and offset I will suggest to you. We have both the same camera, we have the same telescope, we have the same reducer. So this is brilliant, but it helps even more if you have a thicker stack of plexiglass, and you know there's like $12 each, so four is like $50. But a light box with this built in is $600. The flat man is $900 Canadian, I think, and spike a flat I think is $349 US, and now you just save the mint. That alone, with information that I'm providing, this saving you hundreds upon hundreds of dollars. So Bart's gonna stop it here. And then we can upload this part right now because you know that after this, it's going to be called Making Flats Part 1. I'm not going to go Part 1, 2, 3, 17, 18, 19, 20. Why make it confusing? When you look at the video itself, you'll say, oh, this is dark. This is so much simpler to say Part 1. What's Part 1? What's Part 11? So instead, we're going to name them like Flats Part 1, Flats Part 2. You go, okay, this is when Mike shows me how to make flats the proper way. And by the way, flats don't always work, okay? You may make flats at 20,000 ADU and find out that the your black ring goes in the opposite. You overcorrect, now it's white. That's worse. You don't want black, you don't want white. You don't want it too black, that means you didn't do anything. You don't want it overcorrect where it's so white, because why should be a right white ring around your galaxy? Or should there be a black ring around your galaxy? So, what we're doing is we're dividing these black motes with this white flat, and when you divide it, they subtract each other. So the whole screen is gray. The background of space is evenly gray. The donuts are gone. If your donuts go from dark, dark brown to bright white, something's wrong. You're overcorrecting. Maybe your exposures are too long, or your light was too bright. You see? So you'll say, well, then how do we fix it? Well, it's not really a matter of fixing. I think it's a matter of changing exposure time. Okay. You can cheat a little bit by lowering the gain from 120 to, well, it's 101 for us, to 80 maybe. But APP likes it when the darts are on 100, the lights are on 100. And we'll talk about flat darts. What the heck is flat darts? That's coming a little. Wait, actually, no, let's do this right now because it'll make sense more when I'm on Nina, because she'll say, well, he didn't tell me anything about flat darts. So let's continue. Once you're happy with, we're not going to make one set of flats. We're going to make multi. We'll start, let's say, 20,000 ADU. Even if you don't understand what ADU stands for, it's analog to digital units, but it's the brightness. ADU. It's 50% of whatever the full well is of your camera. In our case, it's 12 bits, so, or it could be 14 bits, so it's 32,000. Half of that is 16. But because everything's converted to 65,000, which is 16 bit, half of that is 32. And 50% of 32. I shouldn't say that. 50% of 65 is 32, and 32 is too bright. Like, you know, here's the 100%, here's 50%. And making flats, this is zero. Making flats, we want it like pretty down to 25, maybe even 20, maybe even 18,000. I've had flats as low as 12,000 ADU. So, but 32 has always been too bright for me. 25, 20, 18, 15. Some people who shoot as low as 5,000. This is just light brightness. 50% of the brightness of the light coming in to your camera. Like, this is 100%, like, without anything shooting at the sky. And this is like 10%. So, and all this waving stuff, it'll make sense later on. So now you've made your flats. Well, let's say we'll make a bunch of 18,000s, 30 of them, and then we'll make 15,000. We'll make 30 of those. It only takes, they're a second each. So 15 seconds, you got 15 darts. Or 30 seconds, you have 30 darts, because they're 1 second, not 1 minute, 1 second each. If you go too fast, if you say, let's say your light is so bright, you need to make the shutter speed faster, like half a second, or a quarter of a second, or 1/100th of a second, there's going to be a problem. Because when you do that, you're not creating a flat anymore. You're kind of creating a white bias frame. And I'm not going to explain what bias frames are at the moment. You can look it up online, or Yannick breaks it all down. It's just basically the electricity that's in the chip itself. So on a DSLR, we'll set it to 1/4000th of a second. And it's like, there, as fast as the camera can go. We say, well, and there's no, yeah, and you cover it. It's always, a bias frame is always a black frame. It's always covered. There's something covering either the top of the telescope or something covering the camera. It's a dark frame. But that electrical current has a fixed pattern in it, like the bias frames. And you want to remove that out of the flats. But because this is not a CCD, this is a CMOS camera, like the DSLRs are CMOS cameras, CMOS sensors. And bias are old from CCD eons ago, and we don't use them anymore. So what do we use? Because we need flats, darks, bias, and lights. Well, what are we going to do with the bias, since we're not, what we're going to do? We're going to make so-called bias, but they're called dark lights, or if you say dark flats. Shouldn't have said that. That's confusing. Forget the light part. So dark flats or flat darks? Flat darks. That's confusing. Like, it's a contradiction. You're making flats with the light, but they want to be dark. Yes. If we make 1 second exposures here. How's my video person standing there? She's almost tired? Yeah, I have a back scale here. I'm almost done. If we make 1 second flats that are, you know, bright light, we have to have the same thing here. 1 second dark flats. Dark flats, simple. Watch this. You just take everything down, shut all your power off, remove this. You're still outside or inside in the garage, wherever you're making these. Don't touch anything. Leave the camera run the same speed, same temperature. If it was -5, it's still -5. If it's still a second, it's a second. If the unity was 101.20, it's still 101.20. All we're going to do to make dark flats is take the t-shirts off. Take the flat panel off. Take everything off. Almost done. Put your cap back on. And if you have a big Costco, I'm not sure that in the United States, wherever, Lowe's, put the big black garbage bag. Make sure the camera's not can breathe, because it's got a fan in there, it's gonna overheat. So that's why there's a little grizzly little fan here. So the bag can dangle, that's fine. But make it as dark as possible. Now, without having changed anything, we're making a dark flat or slash bias frame. And by putting the camera on and going to where it says, I don't know if I can show this here, but we go to sequence and make a new sequence. And we go here, bark and zoom. We're done with the camera. That's okay, that we can bark and come closer. In Nina, it always asks you what type of frame would you like to make tonight. So we would make light frames. But there's also flat frames. So you would change this to flat and adjust timing. We'll talk about that later accordingly. You can make dark frames. You know, remember 60 second darks, 60 second lights, they will match. Then the option is, if you have a CCD, you can make bias frames. If you have a DSLR, a Canon camera for shooting around, you know, whatever, going to the beach, shooting birds, you would make a bias frame. See, bias, but we don't use those. We use dark flats. So it's, instead of a white bright light, it's pitch black at the same speed that our flats were. And snapshot, we don't bother with that. But let's put it back on light. And that pretty well concludes the chatter of, and I'll go into detail a bit more, or just at least break it down easy, of, let's put this back in home position, carefully. That pretty well gives a pretty good explanation of the setup, not the configuration or the doing, but at least how you set everything up with the balance. Okay? If I miss something, ask the questions. Ignore this. It's a pain in the butt. And everything else looks pretty good. As you notice that my focus, we'll try to get our focus the same. If we can get these distances, if you can get the 48 millimeters, the DSLR nose cone, this little extension 5. Look where I've got the Astrophysics CCD 6070. It's just sticking out a bit. And you notice I'm at 3. Is it 3 millimeters or these centimeters? It's like 1, 2, 3 centimeters. And as it sits right now on 3, with this distance right here and these spaces, which we should all have the same, with changing nothing, since you put the telescope on the moon, you should already be right on focus, as long as this distance is the same. Because you know what happens if you take that apart. Yeah, Mr. Arson over tightens everything. If you take this apart and you start sliding this, okay? I mean, literally, if you start sliding this in, you're really going to have to adjust this, and that could be a problem. We don't want you coming all the way out here. So I had just kind of, you know, and here's another problem with these kids. You see the looseness, how much slack there are? Welcome to, you know, $100 focuser. They're always loose. You tighten that up, the camera starts to tilt, creates vignette. But we don't care because this is a fantastic telescope, being a Ritchie RC, and this is a really high-end reducer. That's it. We're done. Okay, let's close that up. And I'll get you another video later on coming from the PC if I can find a way to record my screen. You're welcome.